110,000 screaming fans at Phil Beaver Stadium. What a setting for college football. It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams are on the field, and we're just about ready to open things up. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. They'll spread the field with five wide. Loose football. The defense falls on it.
It's not like receivers don't practice hanging onto the ball all week. This is just a case of the defense creating a turnover.
So the offense will come out for their first possession.
Good field position for their first possession of the ball game. Let's see if they can capitalize off of it.
Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 16-yard line. And a quick throw. Knocked out of bounds. Right around the 4-yard line.
A pass like that is so hard to defend because the defender doesn't have a great play on the ball unless it's underthrown. It's all based on connection between the quarterback and his receiver.
Henderson, it's a handoff to the right, and he's tackled at the 3. We've got second and goal. Ball on the 3-yard line. Watch out for a pass play when you're in a goal line D. Touchdown, Buckeyes! Nice run and a score by the halfback.
And a nice call by the coach there. Just give it to your main man anytime you're near the goal line.
He makes the PAT. So a 4-play, 17-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. The score now, 7-0. They line up to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Ohio State's in the driver's seat right now, but it's still early, Kirk.
Yep, very early in this game, but you got to love the feel for it as far as they're concerned. They came up with a stop, and then they get points, and right now they're out of the game.
This offense lost the ball by way of a fumble the last time they had it.
Sometimes when you lose the football, you start to focus a little bit more. So a turnover can actually work out in your favor.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run. He tries to buy some time. He lost the ball, and I think one of the big guys fell on it for the defense.
I'll tell you, when a guy as big as this lineman gets his paws on a loose ball, you can pretty much forget about it. You're not getting the ball back from it.
And as the defense comes back out, you can be sure they're thinking about that score they surrendered the last time around.
So much of the passing game is about the timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. And right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless. Boy, did you see how the defense just swarmed to the ball carrier? That was fantastic pursuit.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on the 37. Ohio State up 7 points. And they make the stop around the 25-yard line. They'll go ground. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. First and 10, ball on the 22. He's tackled at the 20-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. He gets sacked on the play. Third down again. Pass right, running back's got it. And he's taken down around the 22-yard line. The man defense proves to be too tough against the screen.
That was an excellent job by the defenders. They fought off their blocks and found the ball before the play had a chance to develop.
Ohio State is hoping to make this a two-score game. It's up and it's good. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Ohio State's looking awfully impressive right now in defense, but we are in the first quarter.
Yeah, this is about as dominant a first quarter that we have seen in a long time. But let's see if they can continue to play this well throughout the rest of the ballgame.
This offense was infected by the turnover bug their last time out. Let's see if they can hold on to the ball here.
The game is in danger of getting out of hand early. It's very, very important that they not only hang on to the football this drive, but they also need to get a score on the board as well.
Tackle at the 26-yard line. The halfback took the pitch but couldn't find any running lanes.
And there were no running lanes because this defense had so much penetration into the backfield. He would have been lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Here's third and nine. Ball on their own 26. They come out in an empty backfield. That's a great tackle at the 22-yard line.
You have to keep an eye on this guy, especially during passing situations, because he does a great job of getting to the quarterback, as we saw right there.
They'll bring him down at the 47-yard line. 3 points was the result of their last drive as the offense heads out for another. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 47. And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
Well, this is the kind of play you want to see if you're a defensive player, because not only is it a negative play, but this can really impact and affect the emotion of the game. Just looking down and looking at the energy on the field and even on the sidelines, you can see that the defense is fired up after that play.
Going right, intercepted. They'll bring him down at the 48-yard line.
That's exactly what they needed, Brad. Somehow to get the football back to their own offense. They need points on the board, and they need them in a hurry. And that turnover could help them out.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 48. He's out of bounds at about the 43-yard line. The grab, and he's got the first, and he hauls that one in. He's taken down right around the 30. for a nice game. Quick throw, and he's got his man again. Brought down right around the 16-yard line. Good hook up there. They get an 8-yard gain and a first down.
Man, that's another first down on this drive. They've looked really good since they came out on the field.
And he tackles him hard at the 15-yard line. Gets to about the 14-yard line. Third down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 14-yard line. Under heavy pressure. Got his receiver, touchdown.
This team has so many potent weapons. It's tough to try to single out just one of them to stop.
Here's the extra point to draw within 3 points. And he converts the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. The quarterback threw an interception on their last drive. Let's see if they can be more successful here.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
And down he goes at the 17-yard line.
You keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
From their own 17-yard line, it's second down. Ohio State holds a field goal lead. Fires quickly to the tight end. Tackle made at the 22. Good open field tackle. This one will be interference, but who's it going to be called on? It'll be third down again after that penalty.
Yeah, now they have more yards to pick up for the first down.
So with the penalty, they've got third and a mile. Nice run, and he's brought down. Ford, back to return it.
I think this defense has played well enough to be able to win this game, obviously. But at some point, you'd love to see their own offense feed off of some of the confidence that their defense is playing with. Because up to this point, the defense is keeping them in the game, but the offense isn't quite doing enough to be able to build on that lead.
He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. He scrambles. Dives for extra yardage. Caught, and he's hit immediately. On the the throw. Incomplete pass. Third down, and they need to get it to the 28. Throws it. Watch out. Oh, almost had a pick.
It's always big when you can get in the way of a pass on third down because you know the offense is bringing it.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. He caught it, but they're not going to get it. He's tackled immediately. And so now the ball's turned over on downs. We're about set to start things up again. Ohio State is up by three. Gets out to around the 45. From their own 45-yard line, first down. He fights forward to about the 46. And a great ball game so far as we reach the end of one. 10-7, Ohio State. Welcome back. Tight game here in the second quarter as we begin play. He fights forward to about the 49. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45. Zips it to the back. They bring him down in the backfield. Drop back a yard.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
Forward, back deep to return. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Feeds it to the back. Gets to about the 24-yard line. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. And he's level at the 35. Just drops it. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. And he's tackled at about the 45. And they're coming after this punter. He fields the punt at the 13. He makes it to the 25-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Ohio State has a three-point lead. Receivers got it on the screen, and they make the stop at the 30-yard line. From their own 30-yard line. Second down. Williams, left side, and they'll get him in the backfield.
The defense needs to be careful. The safety might have made that play, but if he keeps coming up on the run, there'll be space downfield for the pass.
Dangerous throw. This one's picked off. Inside the 30. And he is drilled at the 23. That was a dangerous pass.
Well, you should have known better than throw that football into coverage like that. You can't expect the receiver to come down with that ball.
First and 10. Ball on the 23. Five wide. And they get nice yardage on that run. The quarterback in the gun with five receivers. And they got to him before he could get back to the line. Throws complete. He's got room to work. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
They come out in a five-wide set. He's tackled at the one. So they punch it in on the ground, Kirk Herbstreit.
Great job up front by the offensive line. They get a good, strong push that allowed the runner to get it in there for the touchdown.
He makes the PAT. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 30. The Buckeyes struggling trying to get their star wide receiver in this game. And sometimes, you know, Herbie, it's almost like a jump shooter in basketball. Get him to the free throw line, get him one free one from 15 feet and see how it can do. They got to get the ball in his hand somehow.
I agree with you 100%. I mean, it's just a matter of just one play, one touch to get this guy going because he has that kind of ability. And up to this point, they've not been able to find a way to get him the ball. Give credit, a lot of credit to this defense for coming in with a good plan. But now it's up to the offense to make their own adjustments to kind of counter that attack by this defense to be able to get the ball into the hands of their go-to guy.
Let's see now how the defense responds to giving up the gain on the run. He's at the 20. Gets out to around the 15. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Quick throw to the tight end, and he's shoved out of bounds at the one-yard line. They line up in the jumbo set. Picked up a yard of anything on that run.
The offensive line has got to do a better job of making space because that was just a punishing hit.
Now he's scrambling, and he's going to be sacked.
It's a big-time effort sack by the defensive end. I want to also give some credit to the coverage downfield. The end never gave up on the play, but because the quarterback didn't have anywhere to go with the football, It gave the defensive end enough time to eventually chase the quarterback down for that sack.
Fourth down. They're going to go for the easy three here. Kicks up, and the field goal is good. They line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Their last drive ended with a touchdown. Let's see what happens on this possession.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
And he's taken down around the 27-yard line. Penn State is up one. Gets to about the 27-yard line. Crosses out to the tailback on the screen. Fumble! And that one's recovered by the cornerback.
Funny, because you usually don't see corners down there picking up loose balls. They're more worried about interceptions.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Flushed out, and he's going to get sacked. What a play by the freshman linebacker.
There's really nothing he could have done against a rush like that.
Looking to dig themselves out of a little hole here after the sack. It's second and 14. Makes it to the 24. He fires left side. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. The wide receiver flew down the field on that touchdown connection.
Well, he has the speed to stretch the defense, and his hands are getting better every single game.
You've always got to be on your toes when you're covering this guy. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Ohio State gets set to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Boy, this has been a fun game to watch, going back and forth and back and forth. It's almost like watching a tennis match here. Whoever has the ball last, my guess, will be the team that wins it.
Here comes the offense. No doubt looking to take better care of the ball on this drive.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially. You know, sometimes the toughest throws to make for a quarterback is when he has a wide receiver wide open, and everybody in the stands is saying, throw it, and you aim the football instead of just getting back in rhythm, stepping, and throwing. And that time, he aimed the ball, and it was incomplete.
It's third down and six to go. Ball on the 29. And he tackles him hard at the 39. Singleton up the gut. He's taken down right around the 42-yard line. The Nittany Lions taking their first time out of the half. He's scrambling. He's at midfield. Brought down at the 46. They'll spread the field with five wide. The go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. They'll bring him down at the 42. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Tackle at the 34. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And down he goes at the 14. Penn State's going to have to use their second time out of the half. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 14. And he makes it out to about the 14-yard line. Throws. And it's incomplete.
There's one the quarterback would like to rewind because he has a wide open receiver and he just misfires.
We're at the 12th play of the drive. They come out on an empty backfield. Slings it. And he couldn't hang on to it. Incomplete. They'll call on the field goal unit here. Kicks away, and it sails through the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 24-yard line. The Buckeyes offensive staff, I think, has done a good job of keeping their wide receiver in the game, even though he's not having great stats. He's part of it, and the rest of the team now is picking up his slack, I think.
Well, this offense is still putting points on the board, and I think at times they're actually using the wide receiver, the go-to man who's drawing so much attention, really as a decoy, open up other avenues of this offense. We've seen other receivers make some plays. They're running the football. So it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments this defense makes to try to slow down these other members of this offense. And who knows, maybe that could open it back up for that marquee receiver.
He heaves it deep. The defender had it and then dropped it.
Hey, that's a heads-up play there by the defender. Get those hands up and something good may just happen.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 35. Ohio State holds a field goal lead. Throws it in a hurry. He gets hit out of bounds. At about the 41. Pulls down the catch and he's got room here. Tackle made at the 48-yard line. He tries to buy some time. Ohio State's called their final timeout. It's second down, 7 to go. Ball on the 44-yard line. So we'll probably get one last heave to the end zone here before halftime. Throws it deep. Can't connect. Well, we can catch our breath at halftime along with these two offenses. What a showing in the first half. 2017, Ohio State.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. We've been looking forward to this game all week, and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like that it's going to be a great second half, and boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
Well, you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this game. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us, and more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, Got to go get it either way if Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half.
He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. At the 30.
He's tackled.
At the 43.
Good, solid return that time. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Ohio State is up a field goal. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds. It's first and 10.
Ball on the 44.
Tackled for a loss.
This is a big-time read by this safety. You know, a lot of times as a safety, you're sitting back there making sure there isn't a play-action pass or a play potentially that can go behind you. I think this safety has that sixth sense. His instincts on that play were special. He read the run, got into the backfield, and made the play.
Run, left side.
And he's tackled
around the 42-yard line. Third down now. They need to get it down to the 34. Quick strike to the receiver.
He's pushed out of bounds.
At about the 37-yard line.
And they make the stop at the 6.
So first and goal after that huge run. Here's a run.
They'll knock him down for a loss.
He was never able to get ahead of steam on that carry.
Ohio State has a 3-point lead.
Touchdown, Bucks.
So the halfback took it in for 6.
Simple play call there by the offensive coordinator. Just give it to the back and let him find his way into the end zone.
And he adds the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
Gets it out quickly.
He's tackled
right around the 48-yard line. So on first down, they go to the air and pick up huge yardage.
Well, that was just a well-executed play. They picked the perfect time to stretch the defense with a passing play, and it worked.
Throws falling back and finds his man. And he's taken down around the 41-yard line.
And they got him for a loss.
I like the combination of speed and strength that this cornerback plays with. He's a real valuable part of the defense.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about 4.
They come out in a 5-wide set.
Throws complete, and he's hit hard behind the line.
This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's taken down at the 28. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Gets out to about the 31. Gains his way to the 39-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Fires out to his receiver. Brought down at the 33-yard line. From the 33-yard line, first down. Out of bounds, right around the 28-yard line. Fires out to his wideout. Gets out to about the 25-yard line. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. There's a missed tackle. They'll bring him down right around the 14-yard line. This is the eighth play of this drive. Big play, and it's first and goal. First and goal from the two. Let's see if they just don't try to power their way into the end zone here. The 1 yard line. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Touchdown, Ohio State. Nice run and a score by the halfback.
And a nice call by the coach there. Just give it to your main man anytime you're near the goal line.
And he hits the PAT. A 10-play, 80-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
So the score now, 34-17. They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession.
Down two possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
He's going to try and scramble. They bring him down.
Well, I think the linebacker here does such a good job of disguising his blitz. As a linebacker in college football, one of your biggest responsibilities is being able to get to the quarterback. And that time, he timed it up perfectly, was able to get through the offensive line and put the pressure on the quarterback.
Defense looking for another sack here on this second and 13 situation. Lee, on the inside handoff, runs outside for a nice game.
Yeah.
pass. Tackle right around the 36-yard line. Complete. He's got room. And he hits him hard at the 42-yard line. After a decent run up the gut. First and 10. Ball on their own 46. Gains his way to the 46-yard line. Hit immediately. Got a man. Watch out here. And down he goes around the 31-yard line. Singleton up the gut. Nice run there as they work the outside. Here's the 11th play of the drive. The Nittany Lions running back left the game earlier with that injury. And what we're hearing now, it doesn't look like he's going to be able to return to action today. Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete. Third down, and they need to get it to the 15. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. He tackles him hard at the 17.
It was a well-designed and executed pattern, but on third down and forever, it just wasn't enough.
He gets it up, and it's through the uprights. Penn State to kick. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 24.
The Buckeyes have shown here in the third quarter, they're not content to just sit on that lead they built in the first half.
Well, they did a nice job in the first half, but the adjustments that they made at halftime have allowed them to find some matchups to their advantage, and they've taken full advantage of that.
The offense will be hoping they can move the ball as well as they did on their last drive.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something, because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
Just throws this one away.
So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down.
Anderson gets it on the inside. Gets to about the 37-yard line.
So with one quarter remaining, the Buckeyes lead 34-20. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter.
And they get nice yardage on that run.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Fires
right side. He's got his tailback. Tackle made at the 45-yard line. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 47. Gets to about the 47-yard line. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Gets to around the 42. From the 42-yard line, it's first down. And he's tackled around the 35-yard line. This is the 10th play of this drive. And he's immediately tackled. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 28. He's on the run. Tackled outside after a nice pickup. And this is the 12th play of the drive. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Side. He gets out to about the 18-yard line. They're really putting a nice drive together right now.
And it seems right now this defense is having a hard time guessing what the offense is up to.
Here's play number 14 of this drive. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
When you're an option quarterback, you get used to getting popped pretty quickly. He'll bounce right back up.
Second down, 13 yards to go. Ball on the 21-yard line. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. And this is the 16th play of the drive. Let's it fly. The defender had it and then dropped it. So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. Kicks up, and it is good. Ohio State to kick this one off. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Caught with room to work. And they push him out right around the 38-yard line. Little toss across the middle. And they make the stop at about the 39-yard line. Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver. From their own 39-yard line, it's third down. He makes it to the 42-yard line. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Caught, open field. He's tackled at the 48. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Big opening. He's at the 30. And he's tackled at the 23. First and 10. Ball on the 23. Just under three to go in regulation. And he is drilled at the 20. With the pass, incomplete.
I love to see a confident quarterback, but you don't want to just go back there and put blind faith into your throws. You need a little bit more time to evaluate the coverage before you release the football.
Fires it out, runs through a defender, and he's in. Ohio State's so secure in the knowledge that they've got this guy that they can go to late in the game.
Well, they can isolate him and get him in one-on-one situations like this. He's going to come up with some big plays. That's exactly what they were able to do there, and he went up and made the big play for the score.
And he adds the extra point. So a four-play, 48-yard drive, and they get it in for seven. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be downed in the end zone for a touchback.
So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. And he just gets rid of it. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Makes the catch, and look out. He's taken down around the 46-yard line. What a play.
What a play is right. Here they throw the ball to the tight end, and the big guy shows that he's valuable not only as a blocker, but as a receiver as well. Nice catch.
Knocked out of bounds at the 43.
Second and six coming up here.
Ball on the 43. They come out in a five-wide set. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. Good pitch and catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him the first down. That's just a nice play.
Caught, and he's hit immediately. Wants to go long and does. Almost picked off.
Yeah, the quarterback's breathing a huge sigh of relief because he got away with throwing what should have been an interception.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 24. They'll spread the field with five wide. Throw Throws complete, and he's hit right away. Makes the catch, but just not enough for the first.
Yeah, they're going to come up a little bit short here. Nice job by the defense of preventing this completion from turning into a first down.
Just an unbelievable stop where they had to have it on fourth down, and that should be the football game. Unable to pick up the first down, and the ball will change hands.
The offense tried to run right by him with the counterplay, but the defense was there to make the stop. Great hold, guys.
And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
From their own 23-yard line, second down. Gives it to the back. They'll get him for a loss.
That play was over before it got started. That was just a case of the offensive line getting beat at the snap of the ball.
This one's in the books, and our final score, Ohio State 44, Penn State 20. As we finish up the broadcast, what do you have to say about how this game turned out, Kurt?
Pretty comfortable win, right about what we expected. This was a strong effort. Ohio State looked like a very strong club. It wasn't a blowout, but you don't have to always run the score up to show that you can play.
For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.